Welcome to Grace for All, a daily devotional podcast from the congregation of First United Methodist Church in Maryville, Tennessee. Thank you for joining us.
Proverbs 3, verses 5 and 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, submit to Him, and He will make your paths straight. Pain and suffering are an unavoidable part of life on earth. And as we walk this earth in 2024, we are likely to continue walking through the valley of the shadow of death, surrounded by things we wish we could avoid or completely eliminate from our lives. But try as we might, we cannot always avoid the deep, dangerous valleys and the shadows of death. Loved ones are diagnosed with terminal diseases. Terrible accidents happen to dear friends. Bombs fall on innocent people. Children die in war-torn places, and we feel hopelessness building inside. We want to trust God more, and plenty of times we do. But in the hardest times, oof, we might falter, and that is not what we need. To trust God more, we need to develop and strengthen our relationship with Him, and that requires more time with God, in prayer and in His Word. In that time with Him, He will teach us to trust Him and to live in His peace when the hard times come. We need to become so trusting of God that when terrible things happen, we can say, as did Job, in his chapter 13, verse 15, "Though he slay me, yet will I trust him." Trust like that must be built up high and reinforced like a siege wall. Walls are built one brick at a time, one hour at a time. And that's just how we must build up our trust in God. One brick, one hour at a time. Yet there are so many distractions and responsibilities to contend with. Hour after hour, day after day, we spend our time on the things of the world. According to recent research that I found online, the average American spends 7 hours and 4 minutes staring at some kind of screen each day. You can check your own screen time on your phone and add that to your TV time and your computer time and your iPad time. Once you've totaled up all that time, compare the total to the number of hours you spend each day reading and studying the Bible and praying in solitude. When comparing that God time to the screen time, carefully note which one is the highest. Most of us will find that the screen time far outweighs the God time. So how can we trust God more than the news when we're spending more time with online sources than we are spending with God? How can we lean on God instead of on our own understanding when we are feeding our understanding with more food of the world than food from God? If we spend more time with God to reinforce our relationship with Him, our trust will grow. If we fall short on God time, our trust will weaken through neglect and it will begin to crumble. With increased time devoted to being in God's presence through prayer, Bible study, and meditation, group study with other Christians, our trust in God grows. We learn that God is our strength and hope, and we learn to patiently wait for Him. Our trust grows, and soon we can say, like Proverbs 3, 5, and 6, "I trust in the Lord with all my heart and lean not on my own understanding. In all my ways I submit to Him, and He will make my path straight."
Dear Lord,
give us the focus and dedication to give you more time than we give to the noise of the world. Help us to submit to you and to trust you more than we trust ourselves. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
In 1740, John Wesley, the founder of the Methodist movement, preached a sermon in Bristol, England, in which he proclaimed, "The grace or love of God, whence cometh our salvation, is free in all and free for all." 283 years later, we're humbled to proclaim that message through this Grace for All podcast. Thank you for listening to today's message of grace. I'm Jonathan Jonas, Senior Pastor of First United Methodist Church in Maryville, Tennessee, where the Grace for All podcast is written, edited, and produced by our lay members. To know more about our congregation and its ministries, please visit our website at firstchurch.org. That's the number 1, STCHURCH.ORG.